find rest as you listen to this peaceful bedtime story. For more Bible stories that bring you refreshing sleep, download the Abide app in the iTunes or Google Play Store.
Imagine it. Lying down in a beautiful, lush, green pasture. Beside a quiet, soothing stream. Not a care in the world. Only feeling refreshed. Feeling restored. Protected. Guided. Consoled. And loved. Yes, there are shadows. There is darkness. But never so oppressing that it's to be feared. Because God is with you. He has been. He is. And He will be for all eternity. The 23rd Psalm is one of the most beloved of all passages of Scripture. King David, who wrote the psalm, grew up and worked as a shepherd. So he knew a lot about sheep and shepherding. He loved seeing the Lord as a shepherd. The shepherd's job is to care for you, make you feel safe, nourished, calm, and peaceful. Whether your life feels peaceful tonight, your Father in heaven is the Good Shepherd and is present to love and care for you. So get comfortable in your bed. Lay your head on your pillow. Pull up your covers around you and relax. Breathe deeply and slowly to calm your mind and body. Breathe in and say this: "The Lord is my shepherd." Breathe out and say, "I shall not want." Relax your muscles. Release the tension from your shoulders and neck. Rest safely in the comfort of your Good Shepherd. This evening, as countless others have for thousands of years before you, settle in as the story of the 23rd Psalm transforms you. Listen now to Psalm 23 from the New King James Version. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for You are with me. Your rod and Your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. As you rest even more deeply, listen once again as you immerse yourself in this verse. The Lord is your shepherd. He is here with you to feed you, to guide you, and to shield you. You shall not want. See his eyes, how he looks at you, the intense care and love, the look that says he knows everything about you, yet loves you anyway. It's impossible for him to love you any more than he does right now. Rest there. He makes you lie down in green pastures. Feel the cool grass, the blue sky, the warmth on your face. Soak up everything you imagine around you. Can you hear the birds twittering happily? A gentle breeze stirs your hair. Smell the sweet scent of the grass and the nearby wildflowers. You are in a safe haven, a wide open space well guarded by your loving shepherd. He leads you beside the still and quiet waters. Hear it bubbling nearby, gentle, soothing, refreshing. Hear it, smell it, dangle your toes and your feet in it. It is there to soothe you. You dip your cupped hand in and pull out a handful of cool water. You lean your head down to drink. Ah, feel the life that it gives you. Drink deeply of the living water that is Jesus to your soul. He restores your soul, your life. Everything is made new, revived, refreshed. In this time of sleep, your strength will be renewed like the eagles. You will run and not grow weary. You will walk and not faint. He will strengthen you. He will uphold you with his righteous right hand. Your head will be lifted up. Your rest will be deep and sweet. He leads you in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Not wandering, but guided down a path, a well-worn path, a known path, a chosen path for you, for you, for him, for your eternity, for his name, for his glory. His light shines on that path. His word is a lamp for your feet. Even though you walk through the sunless valley, you will fear no evil, for you are with him. Yes, there are shadows. Yes, there are storms. Yes, there is distant thunder, but no storms surprise God. No thunder bothers him. No shadows catch him unaware. Rest in his strength, present in storms. See the growth the rain causes. Notice the flowering the tempest brings. God is with you. He is by your side. He shelters you in his wings. You are his forever. His rod is there to protect you, his staff to guide you, to comfort and console you. Gentle prodding, tender reminding, a rod that's protective of you, a staff that serves to guide you away from harm, to comfort you, to console you. Feel soothed now by your heavenly shepherd. He prepares a table before you in the presence of your enemies. He prepares it, the creator of the universe, the author of time. He prepares for you, before you, in the presence of your enemies. God's focus is on you, preparing for you, providing for you. Sit at the table he has prepared. See all the gifts that he has laid out before you. Luscious and sweet fruits dripping with their juices. Warm and yeasty breads that make your mouth water with their scent. Cheese freshly made. All that is good, nutritious, and lovely to behold is before you on a laden table, ready for you to partake. He has anointed and refreshed your head with oil. Feel his hands on your head. Feel the oil in his hands. The oil running through your hair, dripping down your cheeks. Oil mixed with tears. His tears of joy. Your tears of love. Feel chosen, feel loved, feel anointed. Your cup overflows. His blessings don't just fill you, they overflow you. Feel it, see it. His blessings spilling out of your heart, your mind, your body, and your soul. Running over to those around you. You have an abundance to share. God's love, his protection, his nurture, his very self. It's too much to contain. You long to share it with others. Surely goodness and mercy and unfailing love shall follow you all the days of your life. Walk along Stop for a moment and look behind you. What do you see? Who do you see? See goodness following you? See mercy? See unfailing love? Always present, always close. Walking in step right behind you. Listen carefully. And hear those steps. And you shall dwell forever, throughout all of your days, in the house and in the presence of the Lord. Dwell. Not just in any old place, but living and staying as a permanent resident in the house and presence of God. Not an earthly place of sticks and mud, but a heavenly palace built by the Creator Himself. And not just today, but tomorrow, all week, every month, year, decade, century, millennia, for all time, forever. Now, rest in the green pasture, by the still water. Rest safe from harm. Allow God's presence to free you, to save you. Breathe it in, God's peace. And breathe out all of your worries. Our gracious Heavenly Father, our Good Shepherd, thank you for leading us and your precious child to the green pasture, for making them lie down and rest. I pray tonight that they would feel your presence all around them, that they would revel in the goodness that you have brought to them. May they hear your voice of comfort and feel your hands of care on them. When they are afraid, may they trust in you, knowing that you care for them so very much. Take all worry away, Lord, as you walk with them through their valleys. Remind them moment by moment of your care and provision for them. Help them to sleep, Lord, knowing that you will stay by their side. You will never leave them nor forsake them. You never slumber, nor do you sleep, so that they can be sure you are ever watchful over them. Teach them as they sleep tonight to partake of your abundant provision. Help them to see all around them that you have given them every good gift, everything they need for life and salvation. You show them the path of righteousness. You lead them wherever you need them to go. You will never, ever abandon them. Comfort them in your sweet rest tonight, Lord. As numerous as the stars are in the sky, are the grains of sand on all the beaches in the world. So vast is your love for them. Let your love envelop them like a blanket, keeping them safe and warm. Let the clear waters restore their soul. Jesus is the living water, and may they thirst for nothing else. As the deer pants for the waters, may their soul pant for you, the living God. We thank you and praise you for your loving care. In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome to this bedtime story from Abide, a sleep meditation written from the inspiration of the scriptures. to help you relax and release the worries of the day. Tonight, I encourage you to remove all distractions from the room. Get settled into bed and make yourself comfortable. Take a few deep breaths in and out. Feel your muscles relax and all the tension leave your body as you inhale and exhale. Invite the Holy Spirit to be with you tonight. Feel His presence cover you as you wait for sleep to come. Let go of all other thoughts as you focus only on the presence of the Lord and His gift of sleep to you. Perhaps you've never thought of sleep as a gift from God, but it is. It is a beautiful gift of peace and rest that comes from the hand of the Father. Let that sink into your mind for several moments. Now, let's unwrap the gift of sleep tonight. Imagine a beautifully wrapped package handed to you by your loving Creator. He encourages you to untie the ribbon and just let it fall away. He guides you to remove the wrapping and set it aside. He waits patiently as you open the box to discover a beautiful gift, the gift of sleep. Spend a few quiet moments embracing this gift with a heart of thankfulness to the one who loves you and cares about you. Please let me pray over you tonight. Thank you, good Father, for the gift of sleep. Thank you for knowing just what your beloved child needs at the end of a long day. Help them release every worry and concern to you tonight. Please cover them with your peace and protection so they can fully relax and find true rest in your presence. I pray this in the precious name of your Son, Jesus. Amen. Sleep is the cessation of labor. It is the time of day that we let go of every unfinished task. We surrender it to the hands of the Father. He will take care of it. He will guard what we have committed to Him. Take a moment to commit everything to God. Whatever remains undone, it's okay. Let it go. Rest peacefully in the Savior tonight Don't worry about a thing. He's got this. And he's got you. Often, when sleep eludes us, it's because we're holding on to the cares of this life. We struggle to let go of them because we struggle to trust God. We forget that God is the head of our households. He is sovereign over us. As the psalmist says in Psalm 127, unless the Lord builds the house, those who build it labor in vain. Unless the Lord watches over the city, the watchman stays awake in vain. Dear one, the Lord is watching over you tonight. There is no need to stay awake with your worries or concerns. For the Lord does not slumber nor sleep. He will keep watch over you. Rest in that comforting thought for several moments. The psalmist goes on to say that it is useless for you to work so hard from early morning until late at night, anxiously working for food to eat. For God gives rest to his loved ones. God gives rest to his loved ones. You are loved by God. He has given you the gift of sleep. It overtakes you from head to toe. You feel your whole body relax. You close your eyes and take a deep breath in and slowly let it out. What beautiful gifts our Father gives to those he loves. Assurance, peace, relaxation, security, and sleep. Embrace his gift of sleep tonight as I pray. Let it become the prayer of your heart. Heavenly Father, thank you for your gift of sleep. And what a precious gift it is. I am so thankful for your presence tonight. Your love comforts me. Your gift of sleep restores me. Thank you. Lord, I believe you are sovereign over all things, over my life, my work, and my rest. I release all of my anxieties to you. Thank you so much for gifting me with peace and rest tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, sink your head deeper into the pillow and pull the covers around you. Allow your breathing to fall into a steady rhythm. In and out. In and out. feel the gift of sleep envelop you like a soft cocoon. Gently, it wraps around you, securing you in the loving arms of the Father. Like the cocoon of a butterfly, sleep begins to encase you in soft, silky warmth. The strands of God's peace enclose you in the gentlest way possible, for He is a gentle Father, kind and good. From the top of your head to the bottom of your feet, you feel safe, guarded, and secure. Rest in the security of God's love for several moments. Sleep is a gift for our bodies, for it allows processing, restoring, and strengthening to take place. As we drift through sleep cycles, our minds are able to process the day's events. We are able to organize information, file it away, and remember what is most important. Each cell in our body benefits from sleep. It rejuvenates us, repairs our tissues, and restores us from a long day of hard work. Oh, what a beautiful gift from our Heavenly Father. He knows just what our bodies need. He created us. He created sleep. Rest in that assurance for a few moments. Not only do our physical bodies need sleep, our spirits need God's true rest. In the book of Hebrews, chapter 4, we read about God's promise of rest, which comes through faith in Jesus Christ. For we who have believed do enter that rest. We who believe, we who trust, we who put our faith in the Savior of our souls, we enter God's promise of rest. Settle your heart on that promise for a few moments. Now, please allow me to pray over you again. Lord, thank you for restoring your beloved one tonight. Every night, as they sleep, thank you for rejuvenating them. You know just what they need. You are good. You are sovereign. You are holy. Please allow true rest to come to your child tonight as they trust in you. Settle their minds, repair their bodies, and restore their hearts unto you. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Breathe softly in and out. Inhale the sweet presence of the Lord. He is with you. Exhale the remnants of a long day. Release it all to Him. Hear the words of the psalmist again from Psalm 127, a Psalm of Solomon. It is useless for you to work so hard from early morning until late at night, anxiously working for food to eat. For God gives rest to his loved ones. Now, be assured that rising early at the start of a new day, ready to work with willing hands, is a good thing. However, starting the day with an anxious heart isn't beneficial at all. There is no need to be anxious. There is no need to fret. God is with you. Instead of rising early with burdens on your heart, consider starting your morning with a quiet meditation. Let God's word be the first words you hear each day. For his mercies are new every morning. Let his mercies flow over you now for several moments. Then, as you move through your day, no matter what comes, you can recall the sweet words of wisdom you heard that morning. In the quiet hour, before anyone else was awake, you heard from the God of all creation. You can carry his word with you as a guide, a comfort, in a peaceful meditation. At the end of the day, resist the temptation to keep working and toiling into the night. Listen to the wise words of Solomon, who said, "The Lord gives sleep to his beloved." The Lord gives sleep to his beloved. You are his beloved. Each evening, carve out some time to be still before the Lord. Make room in your schedule to thank him for guiding you through the day. Invite his presence into your household. Ask him to cover you as you sleep. Then, as you lay your head down for the night and pull the warm covers around you, begin to unwrap God's gift of sleep. Untie the ribbon of divine rest, open the box, and embrace the gift of true rest in the Lord. His gift of sleep to you. Feel his peace in the room. Feel his presence surrounding you. Hear his words of comfort flow through you, heart, mind, and soul. Inhale and exhale. Continue to breathe softly in and out as I say a prayer over you. Heavenly Father, in the name of your Son Jesus, I pray over this beloved one tonight. I ask that you help them surrender their lives to you and receive the gift of true rest. I pray that they find comfort and peace in your presence. Please help them let go of anything that is on their mind or heart tonight. Thank you for loving them. Thank you for watching over them. And thank you for the gift of sleep. Amen. Welcome. And thank you for joining me for this bedtime story. God is so good. This is a guided Christian meditation from Abide to help you relax and fall asleep. If there is anything troubling your mind tonight, causing you to feel a bit of anxiety, I encourage you to let it go. Release it. Give it to the Lord. He knows all about it. The Lord is good. He hears you. And He cares about you. Take a few moments to relax your body. Feel every muscle release its tension. Breathe in and out. In and out. Get cozy under the soft covers. Remove all distractions from your mind and settle into a peaceful state of rest. In this bedtime story, we will be reminded of all the ways God is so good to us. Even when it seems like the world is anything but good, God's kindness, generosity, and faithfulness is evident to all. The imprint of His mighty hand is displayed throughout all of creation. The glory of His goodness is seen across the heavens and throughout the earth. He is a good, good Father indeed. But before we begin, make yourself even more comfortable under your warm covers. Rest your head gently on your pillow. Get cozy and take a few deep breaths in and out. Allow your breathing to fall into a steady rhythm. Inhale. Exhale. Invite the Holy Spirit to fill the room and watch over you as you sleep. Whisper softly the name of Jesus, allowing His peace to cover you, His perfect peace. Steady your breathing into a gentle rhythm. In and out. In and out. Let go of all other thoughts and concerns tonight. God is so good. He loves you very much. His goodness never fails. You can always count on Him. Breathe in and out. In and out. Relax in the peace of God as I say a prayer over you tonight. Heavenly Father, please cover your beloved one as they find true rest in you. Please help them know that you are with them. Please cover them with your love and your goodness. As a soft blanket, envelop them in the comfort of your peace. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Now, as I share the beautiful reminders from Scripture, the reminders of God's goodness, sink your head deeper into your pillow and completely relax every muscle in your body. Inhale and exhale. It was the Apostle Paul in the book of Acts who reminded the people of Lystra that God's goodness could always be counted on. He encouraged them to turn away from worthless things, things that could not be counted on, and turn to the living God. Now, Lystra was an ancient village, built upon a modest hill, rising from the surrounding plains of Asia Minor, with the grandeur of mountains to the west and to the south. This Roman colony was mentioned as the hometown of Timothy, one of the young men Paul mentored in his faith. Paul visited Lystra on more than one occasion, preaching the gospel and healing a man who had been lame from birth. On one of his visits, Paul encouraged the believers of Lystra that even though the Lord had allowed the nations to walk in their own ways, he never left them without evidence of himself and his goodness. God never left them. Even through trial and hardship, the evidence of his goodness was all around them. What an encouragement! The evidence of God's goodness surrounds us as well. It is seen in the illustrations of nature, as each new day is yet another portrait of God's exquisite artistry. From blue ocean tides and sandy beaches to flowering meadows and lush green forests, God's goodness is evident to all. Be assured of God's goodness, of his presence in your life. No matter what is going on in the world, the Lord is with you every step of the way. Allow that thought to surround you with peace tonight. Breathe softly. In and out. As as Paul continued to encourage the believers in Lystra with the beautiful testimony of the Lord. He pointed out that it is God who sends the rain, provides good crops, and gives joyful hearts to his beloved. God sends the rain. Hear it, falling gently from the clouds to water the earth, like small pebbles hitting the ground in a cadence of rhythmic wonder. Sometimes, the raindrops fall so softly they can barely be heard. Other times, sheets of rain come in waves and torrents, cascading down like a waterfall from heaven. Yet, each drop fulfills its purpose, offering much needed moisture to the dry and thirsty ground. The earth drinks in the rain and silently begs for more. Let the showers of God's goodness fall gently on your soul tonight. Drink in the sweetness of his presence. Inhale and exhale. Not only does the Lord water the ground, he cultivates the earth, causing good crops to burst forth and grow as sustenance for his people. In various places, fields of grain spread out like quilts across the landscape. Some of the fields are circular, some are square, and some are shaped like pieces of a puzzle. Each crop provides what is needed for that region. As you gaze upon the fields from above, you see that some are deep green, like emeralds dotting the landscape. These include clover, parsley, and fennel. Other crops appear like vast treasures of pure gold. They sway in the wind, waving their greeting to the passerby. Wheat, corn, oats, and rye. Fields of grain. Sustenance, good, and perfect gifts from our Father in heaven. Bask in the abundant blessings of the Lord tonight. Continue to breathe gently in and out in steady rhythm, allowing your body to fully relax. Inhale and exhale as I pray over you. Good and gracious Lord, thank you for your presence tonight. You are good. You are holy. I thank you for this listener who has invited your spirit to cover them as they sleep. Please help them rest deeply in your goodness, knowing that you are with them. Bless them, Lord, with peace. In the precious name of your Son, I pray. sense the soothing, calming presence of the Lord tonight. Breathe in His goodness. Breathe out all your cares. He is with you. Paul finished his message to the people in Lystra by reminding them that God is the giver of joyful hearts. Allow the Holy Spirit to fill your heart with joy tonight. It is His good and perfect gift to you. He has joy in abundance. It is a fruit that never fails to be produced in the heart that fully trusts in Him. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who trusts in Him. Taste and see. The Lord is good. Trust in Him and be blessed. You can trust in the goodness of God. Breathe softly in and out. Allow the comfort of the Holy Spirit to wash over you. He gives you the deepest sense of peace, not as the world gives, but deeper peace than anything you've ever known. In the book of Exodus, we read that the Lord God is merciful and gracious, long-suffering and abounding in goodness and truth. Let those truths seek deep into your heart. He is merciful. He is gracious. He is patient. He is full of truth, and He is so, so good. Rest in these beautiful descriptions of God tonight. As you gaze into the heavens on a starry night, there is no doubt that the glory of the Lord fills every bit of space. Unwavering, unchanging. For every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. Every good and perfect gift comes from the Father. Let that promise reassure your heart tonight. The Father of the heavenly lights does not change like shifting shadows. As the hymnist said, there is no shadow of turning with Thee. Hear the soft melody of those words. There is no shadow of turning with Thee. Remain in the comfort of God's unfailing love. Stay in the presence of His Spirit. Rest in the silence for several moments God does not change. He remains steadfast and true to His word. You can rely on Him. You can trust in His goodness. For every good and perfect gift comes from the Father. Slow your breathing in and out softly, gently, deeply. God is so good to us. I am reminded of the simple chorus. God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me. The evidence of His goodness is all around you. It envelops you like a soft cloud of comfort. Sink deeper under the covers. Relax every muscle in your body. Inhale and exhale as I pray over you. Most merciful God, full of grace, I pray over your beloved child tonight. I ask that you blanket them with peace as they rest securely in you. Help them settle into the deepest of sleep so that they will awaken refreshed and restored. Thank you, good, good Father, for being with them tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome to this Abide Bedtime Story. Safe Harbor. Life sometimes takes us into choppy waters, hanging on for dear life. We find ourselves off course, in need of a safe harbor. That may be where you are tonight, in need of rest and a word from the Lord in your dreams. As Psalm 107 assures us tonight, our destiny will be a place that is safe from the harms of the world, like a protected cove. You can feel totally comfortable, peaceful, and anchored in God's protection. Our scripture involves Israel's restoration from exile in Babylon. Just like you may need tonight, they were in need of safe harbor. Every ship has treasure of some kind, and you are no different. You are precious cargo. As you prepare for sleep, know that you are anchored in the waters of freedom and have a carte blanche invitation to explore the depths of God with great liberty. And know, you are welcome here. Before our voyage begins, place yourself in the comfort of your bed or a place where you can sleep. Relax each part of your body. close your eyes. For the next few moments, focus only on your breath. If your mind wanders on the events of your day, and it probably will, gently pull it back in. Feel your breath going in and out. Notice the way your arms are resting on the bed. Your feet feel the coolness of the soft sheets. Allow God to nurture you so you can get the rest your mind and body need. Before setting sail, any good captain needs to have all the necessary tools. Otherwise, his ship could sail right into unfriendly waters and never reach the harbor. The Christian sailor uses scripture and prayer as a nautical guide. With that, let's turn to prayer. If you are anxious, still your heart. We pause to remember that we are invited into the presence of God and to commune with Him. It's the same God who created the universe and hung the stars, who guided the sailors of old. Come home to the deep presence of the Lord. Father, I come before you now. Help me to continue my journey in trust, knowing that you will never fail me, and that your divine purpose in my life cannot be stopped by the enemy of this world. I pray that you will give me a very real sense of your presence in all that is going on in my life and what I am going through. Equip my body, my vessel, for the days and weeks ahead. I pray that you will fill my sails with your peace and will open my eyes to know that you are with me despite the fierce storm that is all around me. Help me to look to you and only you for strength and shelter, Lord. Help me to know that my hope and my safe harbor are found in you and your protection. As I prepare for sleep, please relax my body. Send me thoughts that will quiet and calm my mind and reassure my spirit that you and your angels are watching and singing over me. Please send your angels into my dreams with messages that will help me become healthier. Give me the faith. Oh Lord, give me the faith I need to trust that you will intervene in any situation I present to you in prayer. Thank you for always being present with me and for loving me unconditionally and completely. Knowing that, I can confidently rest in a relationship with you. Oh Lord, hear the cries of my heart. I pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. And with that, prepare to hear the words from Psalm 107. May you open your heart to the possibility that the Lord may have something specifically to say to you as you sleep. In Psalm 107, we find a group who gets caught in a storm while on a business trip at sea. Imagine you are part of this group of fishermen. Psalm 107, 23 through 32 describes the scene. Some went down to the sea in ships, doing business on the great waters. They saw the deeds of the Lord, his wondrous works in the deep. For he commanded and raised the stormy wind, which lifted up the waves of the sea. They mounted up to heaven. They went down to the depths. Their courage melted away in their evil plight. They reeled and staggered like drunkards and were at their wits' end. As you look around, you see boats headed in different directions. Some are headed out to sea, while the others are headed for port. Others seem to be merely drifting, going one way and then another, oblivious to the changing conditions. Stormy clouds begin to roll in, blocking the bright sun. It silently looms over your crew. In anticipation, you scramble across the teetering deck to your assigned position. Shadows swallow the last rays of light, and thunder crackles through the air. Rain begins to pour furiously, drowning any sight of certainty. Monstrous waves of contrasting shades slam your boat. The waves break around the rocks in the shallows, their foamy crests becoming chaotic, lace over the blue. Mesmerized by the swirling tides, the movement of the water choreographs your thoughts as you call upon the Lord. Our passage continues. Then they cry out to the Lord in their trouble, and he delivered them from their distress. He made the storm be still, and the waves of the sea were hushed. As things around you calm down, you notice that some of the other ships reflect the wear and tear from weathering the storm. Others, though, are not damaged. They are taking pleasure cruises or are bound for their own predetermined destinations. You are thankful You've crossed the rough waters. The waves have subsided, yet the air is damp and foggy. Through the fog, a glimmer of light shines dimly. The golden beam slowly rotates. It's a lighthouse, navigating weary captains and their crew to a safe harbor. And this beacon of hope has stood strong and weathered the storm. The psalmist writes, "Then they were glad that the waters were quiet, and he brought them to their desired haven. Let them thank the Lord for his steadfast love, for his wondrous works to the children of man. Let them extol him in the congregation of the people, and praise him in the assembly of the elders." They rejoiced when the waves grew quiet. Then he guided them to the harbor they longed for. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for mankind. Let them exalt him in the assembly of the people and praise him in the council of the elders. As you drift further into a deep sleep, allow the gratitude in your heart that God has delivered you to safety. Flow out to him. While your cargo has bounced around, you are a little rattled, but you survived the worst of it. You are in one piece. You slowly steer your boat deeper into the harbor, where you can see more clearly. Nestled in a small inlet is a mooring perfect for your long anticipated respite. You know that if boats are not secured, they can drift away if a storm occurs at night. So you make sure your tie lines are tight. Now that you and your fellow fishermen are securely anchored, may restful sleep come your way. You feel a gentle rock of your vessel from side to side. Tiny waves gently move along the outside of your boat. Your soul finds comfort. God's hand protects you. He has delivered you through the storm. I invite you now to say in your spirit that you are open to hear the truth of God's word. A word that might be a word from him in your inmost being through your sleeping hours. He stilled the storm to a murmur, and the waves of the sea were hushed. They rejoiced when the waves grew quiet. Then he guided them to the harbor they longed for. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his faithful love and his wonderful works for all humanity. Let them exalt him in the assembly of the people and praise him in the council of the elders. While on the depths of the sea, they saw the deeds of the Lord, the sailors observed firsthand the power and fury of nature. He describes a powerful storm. The ship of your heart is filled with treasure, filled with thoughts of God, which are more valuable than the greatest pearl, the finest cut diamond, or any other priceless treasure man could possibly find or conceive of. So, as you traverse the seas of life, and in times of trouble and turmoil, do not focus on the evil at hand or possible evil to come. As Matthew and Luke remind, rest and be anchored in the rock of my heart, an anchor which cannot slip. Focus on me, and you will stay afloat. God is your safe harbor of consistent hope and endless love. Invite him into the deepest parts of you, and he will anchor you to a place where all things work together for good. Crawl up into the ship of his heart and let him show you how he sees things in this troubled day. Jesus, thank you for being our safe harbor. As you drift further and further to sleep, rest in his loving arms. When the storms rage and the winds blow, when the waves are high, when our very hearts are shaken, strength and courage seem to melt away. Remember the one and only, the one whom the wind and waves obey, the Lord Most High, who can calm any storm. He speaks, peace, be still. In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome to this bedtime story from Abide, a sleep meditation written from the inspiration of the scriptures to help you relax, release the worries of the day, and find true rest in God. Tonight, I encourage you to remove all distractions from the room. Turn off all electronics. Dim the lights and get settled into bed. Make yourself comfortable. Settle your head onto the pillow and pull the soft covers around you. Take a few deep breaths in and out. Feel your muscles relax from head to toe as you inhale and exhale. Now, invite the Holy Spirit to be with you tonight. Above all else, His presence is what you need most to find peace and rest. Just knowing He is covering you, protecting you, and calming you is enough to help you sleep soundly tonight. Take this moment to rest quietly in the Lord's presence. Now, let's pray. Holy God, it is Your presence we seek tonight. Above all other comforts, we ask for the covering of Your peace. Please bless Your beloved child with quietness and rest. Help them release all worried thoughts and concerns to You. Steady their breathing into a soft rhythm. With each breath, help them remember You, the One who guards them and protects them as they sleep. Thank You, Lord, for anointing Your child with Your presence. And it is in the precious name of Your Son that I pray. Amen. If you've ever heard the word anointed before, it may have been in the sense that God anointed certain people to be set apart to serve Him. In fact, Jesus Himself talked about anointing in Luke chapter 4 when He said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because He has anointed me to proclaim the good news to the poor." The anointing of the Lord is precious and purposeful. Settle your mind on God's anointing for several moments. In the Old Testament, Moses was given a recipe for the holy anointing oil. The Lord told him in Exodus chapter 30 to take the finest spices of myrrh, sweet-smelling cinnamon, aromatic calamus, cassia, and olive oil. These were valuable spices that the Lord called Moses to gather. He wanted only the finest ingredients for His holy anointing oil. The purest of myrrh, also called the myrrh of freedom in Hebrew, sweet-smelling cinnamon, a rare spice that was much valued in that region. Aromatic calamus, from the reed of a plant that grew close to the water. God was specific about choosing the finest spices. And from these spices, Moses was commanded to make a holy anointing oil, an ointment blended according to the art of the perfumer, to be used as an oil of consecration. Inhale the sweet smelling aroma of the holy anointing oil as it fills the room. This holy oil was used to consecrate the tabernacle of meeting, the ark of the testimony, and the altar of incense, in order to make them holy for the service of the Lord. Not only that, Aaron and his sons were anointed with oil to be sanctified as priests unto the Lord, that they might minister before him all of their days. This holy anointing was a symbol of being set apart for God. Set apart. Let those words sink in for several moments. Now, please hear this prayer of anointing. Holy God, we come humbly before you, seeking the anointing of your presence. We long to be set apart for you. In all things, Lord, we offer ourselves in humble surrender. For in you we live and move and have our being. Please cover us with the sweet fragrance of your holy anointing oil tonight. Settle our hearts and minds in the presence of your love and grace. We seek true rest in you tonight. Deep, peaceful, uninterrupted sleep. In the mighty name of your Son, Jesus, we pray. Amen. In Psalm 45, a psalm of love and declaration, we read these words about God's anointing over his Son. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness more than your companions. All your garments are scented with myrrh and aloe and cassia, out of the ivory palaces, by which they have made you glad. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you. Rest in the holiness of these words for several moments. All your garments are scented with myrrh and aloe and cassia. The scent of his garments, or covered in the holy fragrance of God's anointing oil. Each strand of Jesus' sacrifice was woven into place by the good, pleasing, and perfect will of the Father. Just as a person weaves beautiful tapestry, ensuring that each thread appears in its proper place, God the Father wove his perfect plan through the life of his Son, so that we could live for eternity with him. Allow the tapestry of God's love and grace to secure you in his peace tonight. God has anointed you with the oil of gladness. Joy and contentment fill the room. The anointing oil of gladness rests on you like a comforting blanket. All worries fade away. They are replaced with God's perfect peace. Oh, how good it is to abide in the peace of God's holy anointing. Abide here now in the oil of gladness for several moments. This beautiful passage in Psalm 45 describes the Lord Jesus as the Anointed One. Your throne, O God, is forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of your kingdom. Your throne, O God, is forever and ever. The security of knowing that God is on His throne allows us to rest assured that He is in control. Over everything that concerns us, He reigns. Above every earthly kingdom, God rules. Let the eternal comfort of God's sovereignty settle deep in your heart for several moments. We continue to hear about the precious anointing of Jesus, as the psalmist writes, "You are fairer than the sons of men. Grace is poured upon your lips. Therefore, God has blessed you forever. Gird your sword upon your thigh, O mighty one, with your glory and your majesty. And in your majesty, ride prosperously because of truth, humility, and righteousness." Fairer than the sons of men. Grace poured upon your lips with glory and majesty because of truth, humility, and righteousness. Rest in those beautiful descriptions of the Lord Jesus. Grace was poured upon the lips of Jesus that He would, in turn, bestow His grace on us. Oh, what mercy, what grace, and what forgiveness. We cannot comprehend the depths of His love for us, for you. Even the deepest part of the sea is not deep enough to hold the grandeur of God's love for us. For all eternity, we will draw upon the waters of the Savior's love and drink deeply from the well that never runs dry. Hear the continual flow of living water flowing from the throne of God's grace. Dear one, Jesus was anointed to bear our sin and shame. He fixed His eyes on the cross out of His unwavering love and mercy over us. His ultimate sacrifice is the foundation of our holy anointing. By His grace, through faith, we are saved, not by our own works, but by the gracious gift of the Father. Breathe deeply, a breath of thankfulness to the God who saves. Jesus, our Savior, holy and anointed one, anointed with grace, anointed with glory, anointed with majesty. Our God reigns forever and ever. Rest in His glory tonight. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is Your name in all the earth. We praise You, for You are King of kings and Lord of lords. There is no one like You. In Your righteousness, You reign forever and ever. And in that truth, we find peace. By Your anointing, we are Yours. You are true to your word, and you never fail us. You lead us in truth and righteousness. Thank you, God. We praise you. In the name of Jesus. My friend, as you drift off to sleep in the peaceful presence of the Lord, there is yet another anointing I would like to remind you of. It is far greater than the fragrant oil poured out in the tabernacle. It is the everlasting anointing of the Holy Spirit of God. For the word says, it is God who establishes you in Christ and has anointed you. He has also put his seal on you and given you his Spirit in your heart as a guarantee. His Spirit is in your heart as a guarantee. Settle your heart and mind on the Holy Spirit tonight. This beautiful anointing by the Holy Spirit is not to be taken lightly. This anointing is the very hand of God on our lives. The very same Spirit who raised Jesus dwells in us. God has anointed us, sealed us, and inscribed on our hearts the guarantee that we will be with him forever. God's promises are immovable, unchangeable, and unfathomable. He has put his seal on us and given us his Spirit in our hearts as a guarantee. Breathe deeply in that unchangeable, immovable blessing right now. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness more than your companions. All your garments are scented with myrrh and aloe and cassia out of the ivory palaces, by which they have made you glad. With the sweet-smelling aroma of God's holy anointing oil surrounding you with peace, breathe softly. In and out. Take in the fragrance of myrrh, cinnamon, and cassia as a soothing balm of peace and gladness. God is with you. He loves you. He covers you with his presence. Most holy God, we receive your anointing hand upon us tonight. We rest in the presence of your Holy Spirit. In the stillness of the room, we breathe in the fragrance of your love. You are holy and just. We abide in your holiness now, hushed and settled. For you alone lead us to safe and quiet places. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your anointing over us. By the seal of your Spirit on our hearts. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, hear the melodious words of these lyrics from the worship song, Holy and Anointed One. Let them wash over you with comfort and peace. Jesus, Jesus, Holy and Anointed One, Jesus, Jesus, Risen and Exalted One. Your name is like honey on my lips, your spirit like water to my soul. Your word is a lamp unto my feet. Jesus, I love you. I love you. Jesus, Jesus, Holy and Anointed One. Rest in perfect peace under the anointing of Jesus, the Holy and Anointed One. Feel the hand of the Father as he pours his oil of consecration over your life. You are set apart for him. You are sealed by his Spirit for all eternity. Rest in that truth. Remain in his presence. Receive his anointing. Heavenly Father, we bow before you tonight, before your throne, in humble adoration. We remain here in your presence. There's no place we'd rather be. Father, we want nothing more than to be set apart for you, to walk in your ways and to honor you. Thank you, good Father, for anointing your precious child with sleep tonight. In your presence, they are comforted and loved. As you stand watch over them in the night watches, they can sleep soundly, knowing that you are with them. Thank you for covering them with your Spirit. They will sleep peacefully in your presence, dreaming of your fragrant anointing oil, making them clean, whole, and set apart for you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Imagine it. Lying down in a beautiful, lush, green pasture, beside a quiet, soothing stream, not a care in the world, only feeling refreshed, feeling restored, protected, guided, consoled, and loved. Yes, there are shadows. There is darkness. But never so oppressing that it's to be feared. Because God is with you. He has been. He is. And he will be for all eternity. The 23rd Psalm is one of the most beloved of all passages of Scripture. King David, who wrote the Psalm, grew up and worked as a shepherd. So he knew a lot about sheep and shepherding. He loved seeing the Lord as a shepherd. The shepherd's job is to care for you, make you feel safe, nourished, calm and peaceful. Whether your life feels peaceful tonight, your Father in heaven is the Good Shepherd and is present to love and care for you. So get comfortable in your bed. Lay your head on your pillow. Pull up your covers around you. And relax. Breathe deeply and slowly to calm your mind and body. Breathe in and say this: "The Lord is my shepherd." Breathe out and say, "I shall not want." Relax your muscles. Release the tension from your shoulders and neck. Rest safely in the comfort of your good shepherd. This evening, as countless others have for thousands of years before you, settle in as the story of the 23rd Psalm transforms you. Listen now to Psalm 23 from the New King James Version. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. As you rest even more deeply, listen once again as you immerse yourself in this verse. The Lord is your shepherd. He is here with you to feed you, to guide you, and to shield you. You shall not want. See his eyes, how he looks at you, the intense care and love, the look that says he knows everything about you, and yet loves you anyway. It's impossible for him to love you any more than he does right now. Rest there. He makes you lie down in green pastures. Feel the cool grass, the blue sky, the warmth on your face. Soak up everything you imagine around you. Can you hear the birds twittering happily? A gentle breeze stirs your hair. Smell the sweet scent of the grass and the nearby wildflowers. You are in a safe haven. A wide open space well guarded by your loving shepherd. He leads you beside the still and quiet waters. Hear it bubbling nearby? Gentle. Soothing. Refreshing. Hear it. Smell it. Dangle your toes and your feet in it. It is there to soothe you. You dip your cupped hand in and pull out a handful of cool water. You lean your head down to drink. Ah. Feel the life that it gives you. Drink deeply of the living water that is Jesus to your soul. He restores your soul, your life. Everything is made new, revived, refreshed. In this time of sleep, your strength will be renewed like the eagles. You will run and not grow weary. You will walk and not faint. He will strengthen you. He will uphold you with his righteous right hand. Your head will be lifted up. Your rest will be deep and sweet. He leads you in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Not wandering, but guided down a path, a well-worn path, a known path, a chosen path for you. For you, for him, for your eternity, for his name, for his glory. His light shines on that path. His word is a lamp for your feet. Even though you walk through the sunless valley, you will fear no evil, for you are with him. Yes, there are shadows. Yes, there are storms. Yes, there is distant thunder. But no storm surprises God. No thunder bothers him. No shadows catch him unaware. Rest in his strength, present in storms. See the growth the rain causes. Notice the flowering the tempest brings. God is with you. He is by your side. He shelters you in his wings. You are his forever. His rod is there to protect you, his staff to guide you, to comfort and console you. Gentle prodding, tender reminding, a rod that's protective of you, a staff that serves to guide you away from harm, to comfort you, to console you. Feel soothed now by your heavenly shepherd. He prepares a table before you in the presence of your enemies. He prepares it, the creator of the universe, the author of time. He prepares for you, before you, in the presence of your enemies, God's focus is on you, preparing for you, providing for you. Sit at the table He has prepared. See all the gifts that He has laid out before you. Luscious and sweet fruits dripping with their juices. Warm and yeasty breads that make your mouth water with their scent. Cheese freshly made. All that is good, nutritious, and lovely. To behold is before you on a laden table, ready for you to partake. He has anointed and refreshed your head with oil. Feel His hands on your head. Feel the oil in His hands. The oil running through your hair, dripping down your cheeks. Oil mixed with tears. His tears of joy. Your tears of love. Feel chosen. Feel loved. Feel anointed. Your cup overflows. His blessings don't just fill you, they overflow you. Feel it. See it. His blessings spilling out of your heart, your mind, your body, and your soul. Running over to those around you. You have an abundance to share. God's love, His protection, His nurture, His very self. It's too much to contain. You long to share it with others. Surely, goodness and mercy and unfailing love shall follow you all the days of your life. Walk along. Stop for a moment and look behind you. What do you see? Who do you see? See goodness following you? See mercy? See unfailing love, always present, always close. Walking in step right behind you. Listen carefully. And hear those steps. And you shall dwell forever. Throughout all of your days, in the house and in the presence of the Lord. Dwell. Not just in any old place, but living and staying as a permanent resident in the house and presence of God. Not an earthly place of sticks and mud, but a heavenly palace built by the Creator Himself. And not just today, but tomorrow, all week, every month, year, decade, century, millennia, for all time, forever. Now, rest in the green pasture, by the still water. Rest safe from harm. Allow God's presence to free you, to save you. Breathe it in, God's peace. And breathe out all of your worries. Our gracious Heavenly Father, our Good Shepherd, thank you for leading us and your precious child to the green pasture. for making them lie down and rest. I pray tonight that they would feel your presence all around them, that they would revel in the goodness that you have brought to them. May they hear your voice of comfort and feel your hands of care on them. When they are afraid, may they trust in you, knowing that you care for them so very much. Take all worry away, Lord, as you walk with them through their valleys. Remind them moment by moment of your care and provision for them. Help them to sleep, Lord, knowing that you will stay by their side. You will never leave them nor forsake them. You never slumber, nor do you sleep, so that they can be sure you are ever watchful over them. Teach them as they sleep tonight to partake of your abundant provision. Help them to see all around them that you have given them every good gift, everything they need for life and salvation. You show them the path of righteousness. You lead them wherever you need them to go. You will never, ever abandon them. Comfort them in your sweet rest tonight, Lord. As numerous as the stars are in the sky, are the grains of sand on all the beaches in the world, so vast is your love for them. Let your love envelop them like a blanket, keeping them safe and warm. Let the clear waters restore their soul. Jesus is the living water, and may they thirst for nothing else. As the deer pants for the waters, may their soul pant for you, the living God. We thank you and praise you for your loving care. In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome to this bedtime story from Abide, a sleep meditation written from the inspiration of the scriptures to help you relax and release the worries of the day. Tonight, I encourage you to remove all distractions from the room. Get settled into bed and make yourself comfortable. Take a few deep breaths in and out. Feel your muscles relax and all the tension leave your body as you inhale and exhale. Invite the Holy Spirit to be with you tonight. Feel His presence cover you as you wait for sleep to come. Let go of all other thoughts as you focus only on the presence of the Lord and His gift of sleep to you. Perhaps you've never thought of sleep as a gift from God, but it is. It is a beautiful gift of peace and rest that comes from the hand of the Father. Let that sink into your mind for several moments. Now, let's unwrap the gift of sleep tonight. Imagine a beautifully wrapped package handed to you by your loving Creator. He encourages you to untie the ribbon and just let it fall away. He guides you to remove the wrapping and set it aside. He waits patiently as you open the box to discover a beautiful gift, the gift of sleep. Spend a few quiet moments embracing this gift with a heart of thankfulness to the one who loves you and cares about you. Please let me pray over you tonight. Thank you, good Father, for the gift of sleep. Thank you for knowing just what your beloved child needs at the end of a long day. Help them release every worry and concern to you tonight. Please cover them with your peace and protection so they can fully relax and find true rest in your presence. I pray this in the precious name of your Son, Jesus. Amen. Sleep is the cessation of labor. It is the time of day that we let go of every unfinished task. We surrender it to the hands of the Father. He will take care of it. He will guard what we have committed to Him. Take a moment to commit everything to God. Whatever remains undone, it's okay. Let it go. Rest peacefully in the Savior tonight. Don't worry about a thing. He's got this. He's got you. Often, when sleep eludes us, it's because we're holding on to the cares of this life. We struggle to let go of them because we struggle to trust God. We forget that God is the head of our households. He is sovereign over us. As the psalmist says in Psalm 127, "Unless the Lord builds the house, those who build it labor in vain. Unless the Lord watches over the city, the watchman stays awake in vain." Dear one, the Lord is watching over you tonight. There is no need to stay awake with your worries or concerns. For the Lord does not slumber nor sleep. He will keep watch over you. Rest in that comforting thought for several moments. The psalmist goes on to say that it is useless for you to work so hard from early morning until late at night, anxiously working for food to eat. For God gives rest to His loved ones. God gives rest to His loved ones. You are loved by God. He has given you the gift of sleep. It overtakes you from head to toe. You feel your whole body relax. You close your eyes and take a deep breath in and slowly let it out. What beautiful gifts our Father gives to those He loves. Assurance, peace, relaxation, security, and sleep. Embrace His gift of sleep tonight as I pray. Let it become the prayer of your heart. Heavenly Father, thank you for your gift of sleep. And what a precious gift it is. I am so thankful for your presence tonight. Your love comforts me. Your gift of sleep restores me. Thank you. Lord, I believe you are sovereign over all things, over my life, my work, and my rest. I release all of my anxieties to you. Thank you so much for gifting me with peace and rest tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, sink your head deeper into the pillow and pull the covers around you. Allow your breathing to fall into a steady rhythm. In and out. In and out. Feel the gift of sleep envelop you like a soft cocoon. Gently, it wraps around you, securing you in the loving arms of the Father. Like the cocoon of a butterfly, sleep begins to encase you in soft, silky warmth. The strands of God's peace enclose you in the gentlest way possible. For He is a gentle Father, kind and good. From the top of your head to the bottom of your feet, you feel safe, guarded, and secure. Rest in the security of God's love for several moments. Sleep is a gift for our bodies, for it allows processing, restoring, and strengthening to take place. As we drift through sleep cycles, our minds are able to process the day's events. We are able to organize information, file it away, and remember what is most important. Each cell in our body benefits from sleep. It rejuvenates us, repairs our tissues, and restores us from a long day of hard work. Oh, what a beautiful gift from our Heavenly Father. He knows just what our bodies need. He created us. He created sleep. Rest in that assurance for a few moments. Not only do our physical bodies need sleep, our spirits need God's true rest. In the book of Hebrews, chapter 4, we read about God's promise of rest, which comes through faith in Jesus Christ. For we who have believed do enter that rest. We who believe, we who trust, we who put our faith in the Savior of our souls, we enter God's promise of rest. Settle your heart on that promise for a few moments. Now, please allow me to pray over you again. Lord, thank you for restoring your beloved one tonight. Every night as they sleep, thank you for rejuvenating them. You know just what they need. You are good. You are sovereign. You are holy. Please allow true rest to come to your child tonight as they trust in you. Settle their minds, repair their bodies, and restore their hearts unto you. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Breathe softly in and out. Inhale the sweet presence of the Lord. He is with you. Exhale the remnants of a long day. Release it all to Him. Hear the words of the psalmist again from Psalm 127. A Psalm of Solomon. It is useless for you to work so hard from early morning until late at night, anxiously working for food to eat. For God gives rest to His loved ones. Now, be assured that rising early at the start of a new day, ready to work with willing hands, is a good thing. However, starting the day with an anxious heart isn't beneficial at all. There is no need to be anxious. There is no need to fret. God is with you. Instead of rising early with burdens on your heart, consider starting your morning with a quiet meditation. Let God's word be the first words you hear each day. For His mercies are new every morning. Let His mercies flow over you now for several moments. Then, as you move through your day, no matter what comes, you can recall the sweet words of wisdom you heard that morning. In the quiet hour, before anyone else was awake, you heard from the God of all creation. You can carry His word with you as a guide, a comfort, in a peaceful meditation. at the end of the day. Resist the temptation to keep working and toiling into the night. Listen to the wise words of Solomon, who said, "The Lord gives sleep to his beloved." The Lord gives sleep to his beloved. You are his beloved. Each evening, carve out some time to be still before the Lord. Make room in your schedule to thank him for guiding you through the day. Invite his presence into your household. Ask him to cover you as you sleep. Then, as you lay your head down for the night and pull the warm covers around you, begin to unwrap God's gift of sleep. Untie the ribbon of divine rest. Open the box and embrace the gift of true rest in the Lord. His gift of sleep to you. Feel his peace in the room. Feel his presence surrounding you. Hear his words of comfort flow through you. Heart, mind, and soul. Inhale and exhale. Continue to breathe softly in and out as I say a prayer over you. Heavenly Father, in the name of your Son Jesus, I pray over this beloved one tonight. I ask that you help them surrender their lives to you and receive the gift of true rest. I pray that they find comfort and peace in your presence. Please help them let go of anything that is on their mind or heart tonight. Thank you for loving them. Thank you for watching over them. And thank you for the gift of sleep. Amen. Welcome. And thank you for joining me for this bedtime story. God is so good. This is a guided Christian meditation from Abide to help you relax and fall asleep. If there is anything troubling your mind tonight, causing you to feel a bit of anxiety, I encourage you to let it go. Release it. Give it to the Lord. He knows all about it. The Lord is good. He hears you, and he cares about you. Take a few moments to relax your body. Feel every muscle release its tension. Breathe in and out. In and out. Get cozy under the soft covers. Remove all distractions from your mind and settle into a peaceful state of rest. In this bedtime story, we will be reminded of all the ways God is so good to us. Even when it seems like the world is anything but good, God's kindness, generosity, and faithfulness is evident to all. The imprint of His mighty hand is displayed throughout all of creation. The glory of His goodness is seen across the heavens and throughout the earth. He is a good, good Father indeed. But before we begin, make yourself even more comfortable under your warm covers. Rest your head gently on your pillow. Get cozy and take a few deep breaths in and out. Allow your breathing to fall into a steady rhythm. Inhale. Exhale. Invite the Holy Spirit to fill the room and watch over you as you sleep. Whisper softly the name of Jesus, allowing His peace to cover you. His perfect peace. Steady your breathing into a gentle rhythm. In and out. In and out. Let go of all other thoughts and concerns tonight. God is so good. He loves you very much. His goodness never fails. You can always count on Him. Breathe in and out. In and out. Relax in the peace of God as I say a prayer over you tonight. Heavenly Father, please cover your beloved one as they find true rest in You. Please help them know that You are with them. Please cover them with Your love and Your goodness. As a soft blanket, envelop them in the comfort of Your peace. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Now, as I share the beautiful reminders from Scripture, the reminders of God's goodness, sink your head deeper into your pillow and completely relax every muscle in your body. Inhale and exhale. It was the Apostle Paul in the book of Acts who reminded the people of Lystra that God's goodness could always be counted on. He encouraged them to turn away from worthless things, things that could not be counted on, and turn to the living God. Now, Lystra was an ancient village, built upon a modest hill, rising from the surrounding plains of Asia Minor. With the grandeur of mountains to the west and to the south, this Roman colony was mentioned as the hometown of Timothy, one of the young men Paul mentored in his faith. Paul visited Lystra on more than one occasion, preaching the gospel and healing a man who had been lame from birth. On one of his visits, Paul encouraged the believers of Lystra that even though the Lord had allowed the nations to walk in their own ways, he never left them without evidence of himself and his goodness. God never left them. Even through trial and hardship, the evidence of his goodness was all around them. What an encouragement! The evidence of God's goodness surrounds us as well. It is seen in the illustrations of nature, as each new day is yet another portrait of God's exquisite artistry. From blue ocean tides and sandy beaches, to flowering meadows and lush green forests, God's goodness is evident to all. Be assured of God's goodness, of his presence in your life. No matter what is going on in the world, the Lord is with you every step of the way. Allow that thought to surround you with peace tonight. Breathe softly in and out. As Paul continued to encourage the believers in Lystra with the beautiful testimony of the Lord, he pointed out that it is God who sends the rain, provides good crops, and gives joyful hearts to his beloved. God sends the rain. Hear it, falling gently from the clouds to water the earth, like small pebbles hitting the ground in a cadence of rhythmic wonder. Sometimes the raindrops fall so softly they can barely be heard. Other times, sheets of rain come in waves and torrents, cascading down like a waterfall from heaven. Yet, each drop fulfills its purpose, offering much-needed moisture to the dry and thirsty ground. The earth drinks in the rain and silently begs for more. Let the showers of God's goodness fall gently on your soul tonight. Drink in the sweetness of his presence. Inhale and exhale. Not only does the Lord water the ground, He cultivates the earth, causing good crops to burst forth and grow as sustenance for His people. In various places, fields of grain spread out like quilts across the landscape. Some of the fields are circular, some are square, and some are shaped like pieces of a puzzle. Each crop provides what is needed for that region. As you gaze upon the fields from above, you see that some are deep green, like emeralds dotting the landscape. These include clover, parsley, and fennel. Other crops appear like vast treasures of pure gold. They sway in the wind, waving their greeting to the passerby. Wheat, corn, oats, and rye. Fields of grain. Sustenance, good, and perfect gifts from our Father in heaven. Bask in the abundant blessings of the Lord tonight. Continue to breathe gently in and out in steady rhythm, allowing your body to fully relax. Inhale and exhale as I pray over you. Good and gracious Lord, thank you for your presence tonight. You are good. You are holy. I thank you for this listener who has invited your spirit to cover them as they sleep. Please help them rest deeply in your goodness, knowing that you are with them. Bless them, Lord, with peace. In the precious name of your Son, I pray. Sense the soothing, calming presence of the Lord tonight. Breathe in His goodness. Breathe out all your cares. He is with you. Paul finished his message to the people in Lystra by reminding them that God is the giver of joyful hearts. Allow the Holy Spirit to fill your heart with joy tonight. It is His good and perfect gift to you. He has joy in abundance. It is a fruit that never fails to be produced in the heart that fully trusts in Him. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who trusts in Him. Taste and see. The Lord is good. Trust in Him and be blessed. You can trust in the goodness of God. Breathe softly in and out. Allow the comfort of the Holy Spirit to wash over you. He gives you the deepest sense of peace. Not as the world gives, but deeper peace than anything you've ever known. In the book of Exodus, we read that the Lord God is merciful and gracious, long-suffering and abounding in goodness and truth. Let those truths sink deep into your heart. He is merciful. He is gracious. He is patient. He is full of truth. And He is so, so good. Rest in these beautiful descriptions of God tonight. As you gaze into the heavens on a starry night, there is no doubt that the glory of the Lord fills every bit of space, unwavering, unchanging. For every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. Every good and perfect gift comes from the Father. Let that promise reassure your heart tonight. The Father of the heavenly lights does not change like shifting shadows. As the hymnist said, there is no shadow of turning with thee. Hear the soft melody of those words. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Remain in the comfort of God's unfailing love. Stay in the presence of His Spirit. Rest in the silence for several moments. God does not change. He remains steadfast and true to His word. You can rely on Him. You can trust in His goodness. For every good and perfect gift comes from the Father. Slow your breathing in and out softly, gently, deeply. God is so good to us. I am reminded of the simple chorus. God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me. The evidence of His goodness is all around you. It envelops you like a soft cloud of comfort. Sink deeper under the covers. Relax every muscle in your body. Inhale and exhale as I pray over you. Most merciful God, full of grace, I pray over your beloved child tonight. I ask that you blanket them with peace as they rest securely in you. Help them settle into the deepest of sleep, so that they will awaken refreshed and restored. Thank you, good, good Father, for being with them tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome to this Abide Bedtime Story. Safe Harbor. Life sometimes takes us into choppy waters, hanging on for dear life. We find ourselves off course, in need of a safe harbor. That may be where you are tonight, in need of rest and a word from the Lord in your dreams. As Psalm 107 assures us tonight, our destiny will be a place that is safe from the harms of the world, like a protected cove. You can feel totally comfortable, peaceful, and anchored in God's protection. Our scripture involves Israel's restoration from exile in Babylon. Just like you may need tonight, they were in need of safe harbor. Every ship has treasure of some kind, and you are no different. You are precious cargo. As you prepare for sleep, know that you are anchored in the waters of freedom and have a carte blanche invitation to explore the depths of God with great liberty. And know, you are welcome here. Before our voyage begins, place yourself in the comfort of your bed or a place where you can sleep. Relax each part of your body. Close your eyes. For the next few moments, focus only on your breath. If your mind wanders on the events of your day, and it probably will, gently pull it back in. Feel your breath going in and out. Notice the way your arms are resting on the bed. Your feet feel the coolness of the soft sheets. Allow God to nurture you so you can get the rest your mind and body need. Before setting sail, any good captain needs to have all the necessary tools. Otherwise, his ship could sail right into unfriendly waters and never reach the harbor. The Christian sailor uses scripture and prayer as a nautical guide. With that, let's turn to prayer. If you are anxious, still your heart. we pause to remember that we are invited into the presence of God and to commune with Him. It's the same God who created the universe and hung the stars, who guided the sailors of old. Come home to the deep presence of the Lord. Father, I come before you now. Help me to continue my journey in trust, knowing that you will never fail me, and that your divine purpose in my life cannot be stopped by the enemy of this world. I pray that you will give me a very real sense of your presence in all that is going on in my life, in what I am going through. Equip my body, my vessel, for the days and weeks ahead. I pray that you will fill my sails with your peace and will open my eyes to know that you are with me despite the fierce storm that is all around me. Help me to look to you and only you for strength and shelter, Lord. Help me to know that my hope and my safe harbor are found in you and your protection. As I prepare for sleep, please relax my body. Send me thoughts that will quiet and calm my mind and reassure my spirit that you and your angels are watching and singing over me. Please send your angels into my dreams with messages that will help me become healthier. Give me the faith. Oh Lord, give me the faith I need to trust that you will intervene in any situation I present to you in prayer. Thank you for always being present with me and for loving me unconditionally and completely. Knowing that, I can confidently rest in a relationship with you. Oh Lord, hear the cries of my heart. I pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. And with that, prepare to hear the words from Psalm 107. May you open your heart to the possibility that the Lord may have something specifically to say to you as you sleep. In Psalm 107, we find a group who gets caught in a storm while on a business trip at sea. Imagine you are part of this group of fishermen. Psalm 107, 23 through 32 describes the scene. Some went down to the sea in ships, doing business on the great waters. They saw the deeds of the Lord, his wondrous works in the deep. For he commanded and raised the stormy wind, which lifted up the waves of the sea. They mounted up to heaven. They went down to the depths Their courage melted away in their evil plight. They reeled and staggered like drunkards and were at their wits' end. As you look around, you see boats headed in different directions. Some are headed out to sea, while the others are headed for port. Others seem to be merely drifting, going one way and then another, oblivious to the changing conditions. Stormy clouds begin to roll in, blocking the bright sun. It silently looms over your crew. In anticipation, you scramble across the teetering deck to your assigned position. Shadows swallow the last rays of light, and thunder crackles through the air. Rain begins to pour furiously, drowning any sight of certainty. Monstrous waves of contrasting shades slam your boat. The waves break around the rocks in the shallows, their foamy crests becoming chaotic, lace over the blue. Mesmerized by the swirling tides, the movement of the water choreographs your thoughts as you call upon the Lord. Our passage continues. Then they cry out to the Lord in their trouble, and He delivered them from their distress. He made the storm be still, and the waves of the sea were hushed. As things around you calm down, you notice that some of the other ships reflect the wear and tear from weathering the storm. Others, though, are not damaged. They are taking pleasure cruises or are bound for their own predetermined destinations. You are thankful. You've crossed the rough waters. The waves have subsided, yet the air is damp and foggy. Through the fog, a glimmer of light shines dimly. The golden beam slowly rotates. It's a lighthouse, navigating weary captains and their crew to a safe harbor. And this beacon of hope has stood strong and weathered the storm. The psalmist writes, "Then they were glad that the waters were quiet, and He brought them to their desired haven. Let them thank the Lord for His steadfast love, for His wondrous works to the children of man. Let them extol Him in the congregation of the people and praise Him in the assembly of the elders." They rejoiced when the waves grew quiet. Then He guided them to the harbor they longed for. Let them give thanks to the Lord for His unfailing love and His wonderful deeds for mankind. Let them exalt Him in the assembly of the people and praise Him in the council of the elders. As you drift further into a deep sleep, allow the gratitude in your heart that God has delivered you to safety. flow out to him. While your cargo has bounced around, you are a little rattled, but you've survived the worst of it. You are in one piece. You slowly steer your boat deeper into the harbor, where you can see more clearly. Nestled in a small inlet is a mooring perfect for your long anticipated respite. You know that if boats are not secured, they can drift away if a storm occurs at night. So you make sure your tie lines are tight. Now that you and your fellow fishermen are securely anchored, may restful sleep come your way. You feel a gentle rock of your vessel from side to side. Tiny waves gently move along the outside of your boat. Your soul finds comfort. God's hand protects you. He has delivered you through the storm. I invite you now to say in your spirit that you are open to hear the truth of God's word, a word that might be a word from Him in your inmost being through your sleeping hours. He stilled the storm to a murmur, and the waves of the sea were hushed. They rejoiced when the waves grew quiet. Then he guided them to the harbor they longed for. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his faithful love and his wonderful works for all humanity. Let them exalt him in the assembly of the people and praise him in the council of the elders. While on the depths of the sea, they saw the deeds of the Lord. The sailors observed firsthand the power and fury of nature. He describes a powerful storm. The ship of your heart is filled with treasure, filled with thoughts of God, which are more valuable than the greatest pearl, the finest cut diamond, or any other priceless treasure a man could possibly find or conceive of. So, as you traverse the seas of life, and in times of trouble and turmoil, do not focus on the evil at hand or possible evil to come. As Matthew and Luke remind, rest and be anchored in the rock of my heart, an anchor which cannot slip. Focus on me, and you will stay afloat. God is your safe harbor of consistent hope and endless love. Invite him into the deepest parts of you, and he will anchor you to a place where all things work together for good. Crawl up into the ship of his heart and let him show you how he sees things in this troubled day. Jesus, thank you for being our safe harbor. as you drift further and further to sleep. Rest in His loving arms. When the storms rage and the winds blow, when the waves are high, when our very hearts are shaken, strength and courage seem to melt away. Remember the one and only, the one whom the wind and waves obey, the Lord Most High, who can calm any storm. He speaks, "Peace, be still." In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome to this bedtime story from Abide, a sleep meditation written from the inspiration of the scriptures to help you relax, release the worries of the day, and find true rest in God. Tonight, I encourage you to remove all distractions from the room. Turn off all electronics. Dim the lights and get settled into bed. Make yourself comfortable. Settle your head onto the pillow and pull the soft covers around you. Take a few deep breaths in and out. Feel your muscles relax from head to toe as you inhale and exhale. Now, invite the Holy Spirit to be with you tonight. Above all else, His presence is what you need most to find peace and rest. Just knowing He is covering you, protecting you, and calming you is enough to help you sleep soundly tonight. Take this moment to rest quietly in the Lord's presence. Now, let's pray. Holy God, it is Your presence we seek tonight. Above all other comforts, we ask for the covering of Your peace. Please bless Your beloved child with quietness and rest. Help them release all worried thoughts and concerns to You. Steady their breathing into a soft rhythm. With each breath, help them remember You, the one who guards them and protects them as they sleep. Thank You, Lord, for anointing Your child with Your presence. And it is in the precious name of Your Son that I pray. Amen. If you've ever heard the word anointed before, It may have been in the sense that God anointed certain people to be set apart to serve him. In fact, Jesus himself talked about anointing in Luke chapter 4 when he said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to proclaim the good news to the poor." The anointing of the Lord is precious and purposeful. Settle your mind on God's anointing for several moments. In the Old Testament, Moses was given a recipe for the holy anointing oil. The Lord told him in Exodus chapter 30 to take the finest spices of myrrh, sweet-smelling cinnamon, aromatic calamus, cassia, and olive oil. These were valuable spices that the Lord called Moses to gather. He wanted only the finest ingredients for his holy anointing oil. The purest of myrrh, also called the myrrh of freedom in Hebrew. Sweet-smelling cinnamon, a rare spice that was much valued in that region. Aromatic calamus, from the reed of a plant that grew close to the water. God was specific about choosing the finest spices. And from these spices, Moses was commanded to make a holy anointing oil, an ointment blended according to the art of the perfumer, to be used as an oil of consecration. Inhale the sweet smelling aroma of the holy anointing oil as it fills the room. This holy oil was used to consecrate the tabernacle of meeting, the ark of the testimony, and the altar of incense, in order to make them holy for the service of the Lord. Not only that, Aaron and his sons were anointed with oil to be sanctified as priests unto the Lord, that they might minister before him all of their days. This holy anointing was a symbol of being set apart for God. Set apart. Let those words sink in for several moments. Now, please hear this prayer of anointing. Holy God, we come humbly before you, seeking the anointing of your presence. We long to be set apart for you. In all things, Lord, we offer ourselves in humble surrender. For in you we live and move and have our being. Please cover us with the sweet fragrance of your holy anointing oil tonight. Settle our hearts and minds in the presence of your love and grace. We seek true rest in you tonight. Deep, peaceful, uninterrupted sleep. In the mighty name of your Son, Jesus, we pray. Amen. In Psalm 45, a psalm of love and declaration, we read these words about God's anointing over his son. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness more than your companions. All your garments are scented with myrrh and aloe and cassia, out of the ivory palaces, by which they have made you glad. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you. Rest in the holiness of these words for several moments. All your garments are scented with myrrh and aloe and cassia. The scent of his garments, or covered in the holy fragrance of God's anointing oil. Each strand of Jesus' sacrifice was woven into place by the good, pleasing, and perfect will of the Father. Just as a person weaves beautiful tapestry, ensuring that each thread appears in its proper place, God the Father wove his perfect plan through the life of his Son, so that we could live for eternity with him. Allow the tapestry of God's love and grace to secure you in his peace tonight. God has anointed you with the oil of gladness. Joy and contentment fill the room. The anointing oil of gladness rests on you like a comforting blanket. All worries fade away. They are replaced with God's perfect peace. Oh, how good it is to abide in the peace of God's holy anointing. Abide here now in the oil of gladness for several moments. This beautiful passage in Psalm 45 describes the Lord Jesus as the Anointed One. Your throne, O God, is forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of your kingdom. Your throne, O God, is forever and ever. The security of knowing that God is on his throne allows us to rest assured that he is in control. Over everything that concerns us, he reigns. Above every earthly kingdom, God rules. Let the eternal comfort of God's sovereignty settle deep in your heart for several moments. We continue to hear about the precious anointing of Jesus, as the psalmist writes, "You are fairer than the sons of men. Grace is poured upon your lips. Therefore, God has blessed you forever. Gird your sword upon your thigh, O mighty one, with your glory and your majesty. And in your majesty, ride prosperously because of truth, humility, and righteousness." Fairer than the sons of men, grace poured upon your lips with glory and majesty because of truth, humility, and righteousness. Rest in those beautiful descriptions of the Lord Jesus. grace was poured upon the lips of Jesus, that he would, in turn, bestow his grace on us. Oh, what mercy, what grace, and what forgiveness. We cannot comprehend the depths of his love for us, for you. Even the deepest part of the sea is not deep enough to hold the grandeur of God's love for us. For all eternity, we will draw upon the waters of the Savior's love and drink deeply from the well that never runs dry. Hear the continual flow of living water flowing from the throne of God's grace. Dear one, Jesus was anointed to bear our sin and shame. He fixed his eyes on the cross out of his unwavering love and mercy over us. His ultimate sacrifice is the foundation of our holy anointing. By his grace, through faith, we are saved, not by our own works, but by the gracious gift of the Father. Breathe deeply a breath of thankfulness to the God who saves. Jesus, our Savior, holy and anointed one, anointed with grace, anointed with glory, anointed with majesty. Our God reigns forever and ever. Rest in his glory tonight. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. We praise you, for you are King of kings and Lord of lords. There is no one like you. In your righteousness, you reign forever and ever. And in that truth, we find peace. By your anointing, we are yours. You are true to your word, and you never fail us. You lead us in truth and righteousness. Thank you, God. We praise you. In the name of Jesus. My friend, as you drift off to sleep in the peaceful presence of the Lord, there is yet another anointing I would like to remind you of. It is far greater than the fragrant oil poured out in the tabernacle. It is the everlasting anointing of the Holy Spirit of God. For the word says, it is God who establishes you in Christ and has anointed you. He has also put his seal on you and given you his Spirit in your heart as a guarantee. His Spirit is in your heart as a guarantee. Settle your heart and mind on the Holy Spirit tonight. This beautiful anointing by the Holy Spirit is not to be taken lightly. This anointing is the very hand of God on our lives. The very same Spirit who raised Jesus dwells in us. God has anointed us, sealed us, and inscribed on our hearts the guarantee that we will be with him forever. God's promises are immovable, unchangeable, and unfathomable. He has put His seal on us and given us His Spirit in our hearts as a guarantee. Breathe deeply in that unchangeable, immovable blessing right now. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness more than your companions. All your garments are scented with myrrh and aloe and cassia out of the ivory palaces, by which they have made you glad. With the sweet-smelling aroma of God's holy anointing oil surrounding you with peace, breathe softly. In and out. Take in the fragrance of myrrh, cinnamon, and cassia as a soothing balm of peace and gladness. God is with you. He loves you. He covers you with His presence. Most holy God, we receive your anointing hand upon us tonight. We rest in the presence of your Holy Spirit. In the stillness of the room, we breathe in the fragrance of your love. You are holy and just. We abide in your holiness now, hushed and settled. For you alone lead us to safe and quiet places. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your anointing over us. By the seal of your Spirit on our hearts. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, hear the melodious words of these lyrics from the worship song, Holy and Anointed One. Let them wash over you with comfort and peace. Jesus, Jesus, Holy and Anointed One, Jesus, Jesus, Risen and Exalted One. Your name is like honey on my lips, your Spirit like water to my soul. Your word is a lamp unto my feet. Jesus, I love you. I love you. Jesus, Jesus, Holy and Anointed One. Rest in perfect peace under the anointing of Jesus, the Holy and Anointed One. Feel the hand of the Father as He pours His oil of consecration over your life. You are set apart for Him. You are sealed by His Spirit for all eternity. Rest in that truth. Remain in His presence. Receive His anointing. Heavenly Father, we bow before you tonight, before your throne, in humble adoration. We remain here in your presence. There's no place we'd rather be. Father, we want nothing more than to be set apart for you, to walk in your ways and to honor you. Thank you, good Father, for anointing your precious child with sleep tonight. In your presence, they are comforted and loved. As you stand watch over them in the night watches, they can sleep soundly, knowing that you are with them. Thank you for covering them with your spirit. They will sleep peacefully in your presence, dreaming of your fragrant anointing oil, making them clean, whole, and set apart for you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
We hope this meditation brought you peace. To listen to the full collection of biblical bedtime stories, download the Abide app in the iTunes or Google Play Store.